Mel Proctor. Welcome to sold-out St. John Arena for what should be the biggest game of the year in the Big Ten Conference. As we check the standings, Indiana in first place with a 10-2 mark. Ohio State a half game back, trying to take over sole possession of first place. And obviously, Billy Packer, a lot at stake this afternoon in Columbus.
Well, there certainly is, and you mentioned first place in the Big Ten. But even, I think, more importantly, this conference does not have a postseason tournament. Therefore, I think the number one seed in the NCAA tournament is riding on maybe this basketball game.
They also have two of the best players in the nation here today. Calvert Chaney of Indiana, the fifth all-time leading scorer in Hoosier history.
He's a great forward. He moves so well without the ball. He's a slasher, gets to the foul line a lot. Very difficult man to handle for Ohio State today.
And the Buckeyes feature All-American Jim Jackson, the MVP of the conference a year ago.
Another great basketball player, probably along with Christian Laettner, the most versatile players in America. They can do it all on both ends of the floor. You can see he had his high against Indiana, but he also had his low recently. Of course, in that ball game against Iowa, I expect him to come out very early today and establish himself offensively.
Ohio State has been almost unbeatable at home. They have won 30 consecutive games here, the second longest win streak in the nation. Coming up from sold-out St. John Arena in Columbus, it's Indiana and Ohio State. Packing St. John Arena this afternoon. And the starting lineup for Indiana. Calvert Chaney up front along with Eric Anderson and Allen Henderson, a talented freshman who missed the first game against Ohio State with strep throat. In the backcourt, Damon Bailey and Greg Graham, who had 25 points against the Buckeyes in game one. And Bob Knight in his 21st year as the Hoosiers head coach. He's won 10 Big Ten titles, 3 NCAA championships. And for the Buckeyes of Ohio State, Lawrence Funderburk, quite a story. Bit of controversy, began his career in Indiana, now playing for the Buckeyes. A three-guard offense led by the great Jim Jackson. Jamal Brown and Mark Baker both had poor games against Indiana in the first matchup. They're hoping for better this afternoon. And the coach of the Buckeyes, Randy Ayers, in his third year, he led his club to a share of the Big Ten title last year. Indiana won the first game, 91-83, at Bloomington on January the 14th. But last year, Ohio State won both games, including a double overtime victory here in Columbus.
In one of the great games ever played in this arena, which, of course, has had a national championship clubs of the Lucas and Havlicek area, and maybe the best basketball game played in all of college basketball last season.
Jim Jackson earlier this week against Iowa was held to a career low 7 points, and I think we look for him to try to get himself going early and take shots a little earlier than he normally does.
It was interesting in that game, Mel. He really never got into the ball game offensively, and that's very unusual for him. So expect a big change here today.
The officials today, Ted Hillary, Eric Harmon, and Ted Valentine. And we're ready to go. Indiana wearing the red uniforms. Ohio State and the home whites.
Mel, always officials are important in a game, but I think particularly in this one, I think Bob Knight's already going to start to work him a little bit because he wants to get to that foul line. We talked yesterday, he talked about how difficult it is getting to be to win on the road, and you can see that that's been true in this league, particularly a place where they've won 30 in a row.
Ohio State 17-4, 9-2 in the conference. Indiana 19-4, 10-2, and leading the conference. Allen Henderson will jump for Indiana against Lawrence Funderburk of Ohio State. And here we go from Columbus. As the Buckeyes control the tip. Whoa.
Well, the official got knocked down. Funderburk didn't realize he was underneath him, so unfortunate way to start.
Mark Baker into Funderburk. Baker and Jamal Brown along with Jim Jackson in three-guard offense.
Chaney on Jackson, man-to-man.
Chris Gent misses a turnaround jumper, and the rebound, Eric Anderson. Indiana will run if they have a clear fast break, but they like to control the pace. Good outside shooting team. This is Eric Anderson, who's been struggling with his shooting. Greg Graham on the miss.
Graham not struggling at all, really playing extremely well now that he's moved into the starting lineup. this Chaney-Jackson matchup. How often do you see two All-American caliber players playing head-to-head?
Trademark man-to-man defense by Indiana, and traveling is called on Jamal Brown. Both Brown and Baker, Billy, had four games against Indiana in the opener. Brown was held to six. Baker had three.
Exactly, and shot extremely poorly. I mean, not only did they not score, they took a lot of shots and just couldn't hit.
Eric Anderson has been in double figures only once in his last seven games. They'd like to see more scoring from him today. And the corner jumper by the freshman, Alan Henderson, who missed the first game with strep throat. And the Hoosiers take the lead. Here's a quick pass of Baker, but denied.
Well, Graham is an incredible leaper and was able to pick that off, even though Brown had an open alley to the basket.
Bob Knight, of course, played at Ohio State. Remember those great teams in the early 60s?
You see this play right here. Brown, he's got himself all, I mean, Baker has himself all the way to the basket, and Graham gets a piece of it.
Jim Jackson with the runner. Tipped in.
There was Brown, a 6'10 high jumper in high school, filling in from the outside. Jamal, full court pressure.
Jamal Brown ties it up. The Hoosiers break the press. Eric Anderson scores, and the Hoosiers regain the lead.
Funderburk went right aft and tried to go for the block of the shot instead of drawing the charge, which I think would have been a better defensive play.
Jackson against Chaney. Jett misses the turnaround.
Jett felt he got hit on the hands there, but it's going to be a little bit difficult for him to post up on Henderson, who's got him by about 2.5, 3 inches.
17:45 remaining in the first half from Columbus. Calvert Chaney leading the team in scoring, but he averages only 12 and a half shots per game. Damon Bailey. Out of bounds to Indiana.
That last offensive maneuver by Indiana where they float as opposed to coming off on the curl is a play that Ohio State's going to give them. They don't want Indiana coming off those solid screens and curling under the basket for those slashing layups. They'd rather have him take a jump shot.
Henderson buries his second shot. So the freshman, Alan Henderson, a runner-up for Mr. Basketball honors in Indiana in high school, has given his team a 6-2 lead. Jackson showing his one-on-one ability.
As I said at the top, you expected Jim Jackson to start coming out immediately and becoming an offensive threat.
Full court pressure by the Buckeyes.
Well, Indiana can throw over the top of that press because they've got three-on-one on the other end.
Henderson on the miss, Henderson on the follow. And he scored 6 of the 8 Indiana points as the Hoosiers lead 8-4.
As you mentioned, Mel did not even play in the first game.
Jamal Brown slips inside. That counts.
He got Bailey with a head fake. Jimmy Jackson, actually, Chaney assumed that Jackson was going to put the ball back out into the offensive position at the top of the key. When Jackson reversed himself, he was wide open inside for a solid layup.
The foul is on Eric Anderson of Indiana. Jamal Brown's basket counts. Brown exploded for a career-high 29 last year against Indiana. The Buckeyes' 93-85 victory in January. Senior from Arlington, Texas.
And also has played some great defensive ball this year. Did a job on Woody Austin from Purdue.
Greg Graham runs into Damon Bailey. Ran into his own man.
Henderson 4-on-1. Oh! Now, that was a solid play by Henderson. I don't think there was anything nasty about that play at all except the fall. Henderson was trying to do his job, hang in there for the block. We'll see what happens here. Graham runs into Bailey, who turns around and just knocks him to the floor. And then, of course, the steal by Brown going all the way. And you'll see Henderson. He did all he could to go up there and try to make the block on the play. It was just a hard-nosed basketball play. Really, what Brown should have done, he had a 4-on-1. He should have given the ball back, made for a nice, easy layup.
So the foul is on Alan Henderson. Brown, a 74% free throw shooter. Mel Proctor with Philly Packer at sold out St. John Arena in Columbus, Ohio. Capacity here is 13,276. There is not an empty seat that I can see.
Good comeback by Brown to get up off the floor. Solid senior. And there's what I thought was available. Throw over the top of that press and then try to convert down the other end on a 2-on-1 and 3-on-2. Straight man-to-man by both teams. Hard-nosed defense being played here.
And a foul away from the ball on Chris Jent, who's guarding Calvert-Cheney. Jent, an excellent defensive player, a little overzealous that time when he picks up the foul.
Well, he got caught on a switch. That's the first time Jimmy Jackson wasn't on Cheney.
Randy Ayers talking to the official. He's normally pretty calm on the sidelines, a contrast to Bob Knight.
Yeah, he may be calm, but I think people respect him early on here in his coaching career as a fierce competitor and has an awful lot of respect in the Big Ten.
Cheney's shot denied by Funderburk. The ex-Indiana Hoosiers slaps it away. Here's Baker on the drive.
Lawrence Funderburk has really established himself as an outstanding shot blocker. We had him against Seton Hall earlier in the year when he was just starting to get into the flow of things here at Ohio State. But he is a super blocker because he is so quick off his feet and has excellent timing.
A 2-on-1 fast break. Jent behind the back to Baker. Ohio State has scored 8 unanswered points.
See, David Bailey is trying to throw the ball on the baseline. The man that's open is Allen Henderson all the way up at half court.
And Indiana will take a timeout as the Buckeyes have run off 8 unanswered points. Tournament just around the corner. Boy, well, there were some upsets yesterday. UCLA losing to Notre Dame. North Carolina was upset by NC State. That's an offensive foul on Graham. His first foul.
You know, Mel, in the first game, you had Graham and Bailey scored 50 points, 25 each against Ohio State. Here we are, more than halfway through the first half of this game, and the entire backcourt regime of Indiana has not yet scored a point. 0 for 7 in shooting, no points.
Ohio State's backcourt has outscored Indiana's 18-0. Jim Jackson buries it, and the Buckeyes go back up by 8. That's his second basket.
Well, that 3-inch height advantage Jackson has just goes right over the top of Bailey.
The Hoosiers have made only 2 of their last 11 field goal attempts, and are shooting just 35% for the half.
I think the real key has been Ohio State's ability to prevent dribble penetration by Indiana.
Calvert Cheney scores for Indiana to make it 28-22 Ohio State.
That was beyond dribble penetration. When you can reverse and take that jumper on the baseline, that's just a big-time play.
Cheney now has 10 points. Jackson, batted shot,
nice.
Stolen by Graham. We've got a foul. Although Jent blocked the shot.
Just excellent plays all the way around. Here we're going to see Calvert Cheney going against one of the best defenders in Brown in the Big Ten. He takes him, then he reverses and feels the double team coming over and still goes up strong for the jump shot.
Foul is called on Mark Baker. That's his first. And the 15 foul.
You know, Jim Jackson made a nice move down the other end, Mel, and he had a great idea to throw it out to the wing for an open jumper. Just that Graham made a sensational defensive play in timing the steal.
Randy Ayers, who one of the tallest coaches in the country, he's 6'6", a former player himself at Miami of Ohio, and was drafted by the Chicago Bulls. Did a terrific job here in Columbus, and his Buckeyes lead by 5. Baker. Jent with a strong rebound, but he stepped out of bounds.
That was a good job by Jent to come not pick up the foul. Look at that backcourt scoring, 24-1. As I pointed out in the first game, the backcourt for Indiana, 2 of them had 50 points.
And a foul is called on Jim Jackson of Ohio State. That's his first, and the 16 foul.
Good play by Bailey to split that double team and push the ball out in front of him, as opposed to putting it down quickly to his body, which would enable Ohio State to come up with a steal.
6:50 remaining first half from Columbus. Ohio State leading by 5. Calvert Cheney having a good first half on the pull-up, rebounded by Jent. His 6th rebound of the game.
Hey, when you've got a big man that'll run like Funderburk, you've got to get him the ball down inside on some of those semi-breaks.
Funderburk.
That man's got something to prove, doesn't he, Mel?
Oh, you bet. Looked like the ball was kicked by Graham. Funderburk has 6 points now. Here's Graham. Blocked by Funderburk. Holy mackerel, what a block.
And he's slapping coming down the court. He's having a good time out here. It's really interesting talking to him yesterday. When he was dismissed from his team in his senior year in high school, he said he was trying to decide between Indiana and North Carolina, and he made up his mind to pick the school that called him first. Bob Knight called first, and he chose Indiana.
Well, he'd been kicked off his high school team his senior year, and he felt there'd be a lack of interest in the part of the colleges, so that's why he said, whoever calls first, that's where I'm going.
Yep. And interesting what goes through the minds of kids that are 18, 19 years old.
Graham buries a three-pointer to make it 30-26 Ohio State. 5:48 remaining in the half. Jackson.
Oh, what a shot.
Big time move by JJ to make it 32-26.
Good split by Meeks.
Chaney traveled.
Delayed call there. Meeks made a good play, but then he went up in the air. If he just made a good two-handed chest pass, he's got something going there. They're going to see Jackson. He put the ball back behind his head. Fortunately, did not make contact with his left hand and scored over Graham, who's an excellent leaper.
Jackson is so strong in the upper body.
He's playing Damon Bailey. He's got him down in the low post now.
Funderburk. He loves to shoot that left-hand jump hook.
Not a good shot. And a good block out by Bailey on Jackson. Jackson a little upset because he knew that Lawrence probably shouldn't have put that one up.
Chaney's been most of the offense for the Hoosiers so far.
So here's that solid defense on the dribbler by Ohio State's guards.
Good entry pass. Henderson got it. He's played well. 12 points for the freshman, Alan Henderson, who's from Carmel, Indiana. Whoa. Jamal Brown ran into Calvert Chaney, but the foul will be called on Chaney.
Well, what Indiana players are doing now, and that's an unusual call there. They realize Ohio State is trying to set solid screens and then pop out. Now watch what happens. Here's a solid screen. And the reason for the call is you have got to allow the cutter to come through there. Chaney just tried to jump over in front. And he's the one that initiated the contact. So they're actually, Indiana's defense is playing Ohio State's play.
That's the 16th foul on Indiana.
Well, that was an illegal screen. Now, that's Brandewey, sure, without question. He goes and creates the contact on that one.
They sure do banging with those screens, though.
This was more than a foul here. You watch Brandewey. Boom. Boom, he just knocks him away. If he had held his ground just nice and solid, it would have been a pretty good screen.
In the roller derby, that would have been allowed. It's a nice move.
Yeah. He had his feet planted. He had given a proper distance, but then he went a little extracurricular activity with the elbows.
That's the 17th foul, so Calvin Chaney will shoot a 1-1. Both these teams are excellent free throw shooting teams, above 70%.
Indiana at 73, yeah. Kind of interesting, the guy that goes to the line most on this team is a fellow that didn't even start that much, was Greg Graham. He's been to the line 135 times coming into the game. Shows you how well he penetrates.
Chaney converting both free throws. He now has 12 points, and it's a two-point Buckeye lead with 4.5 remaining.
Well, you get a sense that Ohio State is in the lead, a comfortable margin, until you look at the scoreboard, you know?
That's right.
There's a double team by Chaney.
Funderburk wants the ball, working against Eric Anderson. Chris Gent takes it inside.
Boy, that was an excellent defensive series by Indiana, and Gent broke it down with a good penetration. Indiana really had him stymied on that sequence.
That's Gent's first basket, but he's done an excellent job on the boards. Good pressure by Brown on Meeks.
And he's trying to force Meeks to go all the way to the basket.
Greg Graham scores. He's beginning to heat up. And it's 34-32 Buckeyes. Graham now has 6.
You kind of get a feeling that maybe Knight likes this lineup he's got on the floor with Damon Bailey out of there right now.
Meeks trying to draw a charge. Baker misses the jumper. Brandaway with a rebound. Baker backs it out. Plenty of time left on the shot clock. Good patience by the Buckeyes.
Yeah, excellent, particularly with Jimmy Jackson out of the game right now.
Gent.
Good hands by Henderson.
Indiana with a chance to take the lead. A three-pointer would give them the lead. A two-pointer would tie it. Greg Graham for three.
Probably be Henderson getting there a little late.
That's his second foul and the 17th foul, so a 1-1 coming up for Ohio State.
Well, now you mentioned Indiana with a chance to take the lead, and that in the first game this year was incredible, the runs. Ohio State behind made a 26-2 run to take the lead, and then Indiana buried him at the end with a 20-6 run to pull away.
It's also a run to start the game. Indiana jumped out to a 15-2 lead in that game. This one has been much tighter. Funderburg gets another breather, really having a tremendous first half.
Well, he did not obviously start in that last game against Ohio State. And we're just starting to get into the flow of things. You can expect his production the rest of the way to really be significant for this team.
Tom Brandaway, a junior from Fort Laramie, Ohio. Damon Bailey is back in for Indiana, replacing Henderson.
I think Brandaway is a very good substitution for Randy Ayers in this game as opposed to Robinson because of the quickness he's going to have to face on the floor.
The Buckeyes increase their lead to 36-32 on Brandaway's free throws. Columbus with Ohio State leading 36-32. The backcourt scoring remains a key. The Buckeyes backcourt outscoring Indiana's 26-6 so far.
Showed a little different press that time. Didn't pick up full court. Looks like they're going to drop back into a zone. 1-2-2 zone playing by Ohio State for the first time here in the first half.
What's the key to attacking this particular zone?
Well, Indiana likes to attack by slashing into those gaps with the dribble and being very patient with the ball. Here, Bailey almost had an opportunity to do it. They like to swing the ball all the way across, a lot of skip passing. Problem is, Anderson hasn't been shooting well, and he'd be one of the guys that you'd be able to skip pass over for the jump shot.
Here he is. Anderson puts it up. Still struggling with his shooting.
It is a very flat shot. I talked to Ron Felling before the game, and he said he just is trying to get more lift on that shot, trying to get more arch on it. You can see his shot is extremely flat.
He's 1-for-3 from the floor so far. With his recent slump, his shooting has dipped below 50% for the season. We're under 2 minutes. Ohio State with a 4-point lead.
Another very smart move by Randy Ayers, I think, going to the zone. And the fact that you make Indiana work on something else before they go into halftime. They showed the zone one time, now they get back to their man-to-man.
Chaney. Having a good first half is Calvert Chaney with 14 points, and that cuts the Ohio State lead to 2.
Got to be thinking Jimmy Jackson. He's got Bailey on him. Here he is. Used his left hand. Got by with it that time.
Bailey with the lead pass to Reynolds. The lob.
Oh, boy, on the money there. Now, with Funderburk out of the game, you know, Chaney not contested up high. I got to let Jimmy Jackson handle the ball here some, particularly if he can get back with Damon Bailey down the low post.
Jackson posting up on Chaney. Brandaway puts it up.
And they're getting the shots by the wrong people now, and it's costing Ohio State.
Less than a minute remaining. Bailey for 3.
Now, with only 40 seconds, you're not going to call a timeout, but it's critical now for Ohio State to make sure Jackson and Bailey is the matchup and get the ball to Jim Jackson down in the low post.
That's the first basket for Damon Bailey, a three-pointer to give the Hoosiers the lead.
Going to a little four-corner, spreading things. Shot clock off, we're down to 19. Jimmy Jackson wants him to bring the ball over his direction. They better start going now. It's a clear out for Baker.
Mark Baker connects to make it 39-38 Hoosiers. They try to get off a final shot.
Taking two.
Bailey for three. Oh, that counts!
Went in there. That's part of that legend.
The legend of Damon Bailey.
Here he comes. Hits two threes in a row. This is more than a three. Puts it up. Almost got fouled on the play and drilled it.
So Bailey, who was quiet for most of the half, hitting 2 3-pointers, one to give his team the lead, the second to close out the half. And it's 42-38 Indiana at halftime. Jim Nance will be along with Prudential at the half, live from the Olympic Broadcast Center in Moutier, France, after this word and a message from your local station. Up front along with Eric Anderson and Alan Henderson. Here's Henderson, who got off to a fast start. And he opens the second half scoring.
Beautiful move and that extra little patience that he showed to knock Funderburg off stride, but he couldn't get over there for the block.
14 points now for Alan Henderson. It's Baker, Jackson, and Brown along with Gent and Funderburg for Ohio State starting the second half.
There's that little screen inside for the rollout for Jackson, and Funderburg not being able to get in position for the rebound, fouls over the shoulder.
That's his first foul. He was certainly a force defensively with four blocks in the first half.
Jackson now 3 for 8 and Gent 1 for 6. So where you expected solid performance from Ohio State, they're not getting it in that front line.
Both players had big games against Indiana in the first. Gent had 18 and J.J. Jim Jackson had 31, matching his career high. So those two have got to get going if Ohio State hopes to win. Calvert Chaney unloads.
Boy, that was a bad move by Ohio State. They got caught in this mismatch. Baker on Chaney. Chaney just shoots right over the top of him.
His three-pointer gives him 19 points. Gent with a strong drive, but loses the ball. Brown can't put it down.
And Indiana's got the numbers on the break. Henderson's going to be open.
Eric Anderson takes it inside. Foul rough. An official goes down.
I think the foul is going to be called before the shot. Same official that was chopped at the opening tap. This one a little bit more of a severe fall. Let's see about the basket. I don't think it should count. They're going to call walking, actually, not only before, you see the official going down, not only before the basket, but also no foul.
They go walking on the official.
Yeah. Well, he'd like to be walking. He's going to be walking slowly, that's for sure. Tough ball.
The crowd trying to get Ohio State back in the game as they've fallen behind by 9 points. This is Indiana's biggest lead. Baker for three. Air ball.
You know, he really has a hard time when he has to extend that range out beyond 18 feet. It really changes his shot quite a bit.
You got to know your limitations in this game.
Yeah, he has a tendency to fade backwards on a jump shot. And I think the farther out he gets, the more difficult it is for him to get it up there on the release.
Mark Baker hits 6 of 11 shots in the first half. Ohio State hits the Hoosiers with a full-court press. Bailey hit those 2 3-pointers to close out the first half, his only baskets of the half.
Remember when Indiana in the first half was against the press, was holding the ball deep in the backcourt. Now they are throwing over the top, and that's why they're getting the numbers against it.
Greg Graham was 2 for 8 in the first half. Bailey gets an open shot.
Good screen by Calvert Chaney. Bailey moves so well without the ball. He's getting in the flow now.
And the great
Jerry Lucas,
former Ohio State All-American, has joined us. Good to see you, Jerry.
Thanks, Mal. Nice to see you.
What do you think of the game so far?
Well, I enjoyed the beginning a little bit more than I do right now. Of course, Indiana is playing very well, and I'd like to see the Buckeyes turn it up a notch. It's a great game so far, obviously.
Jerry was the only 3-time MVP in the history of the Big Ten. Jerry, you've got a guy playing out here for Ohio State now that's got a chance to do that if he wants to stick around, but he's not having a big game so far.
Well, he's not. He played, obviously, he's played a lot better, but if he sticks around, I think he will be the MVP for 3 years in the Big Ten. I'd love to see that happen. Of course, Ohio State fans would love to see him stay, but he has the ability right now, Billy. I think we both understand that, to go on if he wants to.
How about the man that's coaching Indiana? Did you ever expect when you fellas were back in school that he'd end up coaching against you as a rival?
Well, I always knew that he would be a great coach. Bob has always been very intense, very intelligent, very interested in the game, and he's always loved the game, and I felt he would be one of the great coaches, and he has proven to be one of the greatest of all time.
Indiana leading 49-41. No Proctor, Billy Packer, and Jerry Lucas with us. Jerry, what are you doing these days? A lot of people would like to know.
Well, I write educational curriculum, Bill. I write educational curriculum for educators, for teachers and schools, and teach people how to learn. I've written about 35 books in memory training and learning systems, and really want to make an impact on the educational system in America.
Well, Jerry, thank you for being with us. Good to see you.
It's good to be with you.
When Jackson gets there late, we see a block down the other end. Anderson driving to the basket, and again, Lawrence Funderburk just grabbing it. His quickness off the floor and his timing are just so good.
He has 5 block shots today. Jim Jackson picking up his 2nd foul. It's 49-41 Indiana with 17 minutes remaining.
That's a much better matchup now. Brown working on Damon Bailey and Jackson on Cheney.
Eric Anderson has been very quiet again today.
Yes, he has. But what Indiana's doing right now is forcing Ohio State to work so hard on defense with a patient offensive movement.
Allen Henderson works his way in, but he's called for traveling. That's the 7th turnover by Indiana.
Now, Knight looking for a little help here, but that was just solid defense by Ohio State going up against very good movement by Indiana.
Does Jim Jackson need to start looking for his shot a little bit?
I think so, and I think Ohio State has to start looking for him a little more. There he goes. I think they take for granted that Jim can do whatever he wants when he wants to, but they have to start getting him the ball in shooting position a little more.
He cuts the lead to 6. Bailey scores with a runner.
Pretty clever. He knew he had Jackson on his back and just kept him there and then glided at the last second.
10 points for Damon Bailey. Jackson goes one-on-one against Cheney.
Funderburk's got position. Pat Anderson right on his back.
8 points for Lawrence Funderburk.
We're going to have a little conversation here now between two players. We're going to see, there's what Bailey. He knew that Jackson was behind him, so he just kind of kept him there and then made the big stride to get the glide shot off.
No fouls were called, just a word of caution by the officials. It's a block called on Gent, not a popular call here at St. John Arena. That's his 3rd foul.
Well, one thing you can say about Gent, he is not having a big day offensively, but he's trying to give the club all the other things he can.
Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the General Scholarship Fund of each school. Mel Proctor with Billy Packer back in Columbus with Indiana leading 51-45 with 15:48 remaining in the 2nd half. Ohio State in a man-to-man. They have played zone briefly in this game. Calvert Cheney with a turnaround. He's got 21 points now.
And that's 9 out of the last 10 field goals Indiana has made since the beginning of the last few minutes of the first half and in here to the 2nd half. They're running their offense to really perfection. You know, Ohio State is just not getting the ball to Jim Jackson enough.
Foul is called on Cheney trying to guard Jackson.
And now, we talked before the game. In my estimation, Jim Jackson should have the ball a lot more than Calvert Cheney. You can see he only had the ball in his possession up to this point in the game, 1:10. Cheney, who's usually the guy moving without the ball and the recipient, has had the ball 1 minute. And so if you're Ohio State, you've got to get the ball in Jim Jackson's hands, let him make plays and score more.
You want to compare the two for the season. Jackson averages 16.5 shots per game. Cheney, 12.5. Jackson.
He ought to go up. Good move. And Anderson did a good job not chopping him.
Indiana leading by 8. Eric Anderson.
Still struggling.
Funderburk with a strong rebound. He has 6 rebounds.
Here's Jackson on the wing.
JJ with a runner over Cheney.
And I think they should just turn him loose for a couple of minutes here and force Indiana to take so much defensive pressure on to stopping Jackson that somebody else will be open.
And with Indiana playing a man-to-man, why not clear out a side and let him go one-on-one?
Boy, Henderson, who started out this game and took things over early on, playing a solid game the whole way.
He's got 16 points now. Baker knocks it down. 55-49 Indiana.
The press not being as big a factor as it was early on in this ball game. Indiana seemed to be content just to get the ball in bounds instead of attacking.
Damon Bailey.
I would imagine Bob Knight wanted more passes on that exchange. Nice
round to Baker, blocked by Eric Anderson.
Second great defensive play Anderson has made the last three times down the floor.
He may not be scoring much, but he's made two fine defensive plays. 13-38 remaining second half. The Hoosiers lead by six. Bailey for three.
That shows some confidence, doesn't it? Misses the jumper from the side, comes right back out.
Up until the last minute of the first half, he was scoreless, and he hit a three-pointer to give his team the lead. Hit a desperation three-pointer to pad the lead, and now he's got it going. He's got 13 points.
That was supposed to be a solid screen by Funderburk on Baker, and then set up Jim Jackson down the low post, but the play was not executed properly.
Gent from long range, a three-pointer.
Now he's been really quiet offensively so far today. It's only his second field goal.
That cuts the Hoosier lead to six. Greg Graham, it was open, but passed up the shot. Calvert Cheney, blocked by Funderburk. And a slam Henderson. By Henderson.
Funderburk came all the way across the lane to get that one. That's his sixth block today.
Chris Gent takes it to the hole. This will be a blocking foul on Indiana.
Well, what happened is Jim Jackson lost Cheney, and he couldn't get back in time, so Cheney's going to take it to the hoop for the dunk. Funderburk comes over there, gets a piece, but Henderson was able to pick it up and put it away.
Foul is called on Damon Bailey. That'll send Gent to the free throw line.
Now Gent made that three-pointer, and then he put the ball down on the floor and with good penetration there. So we're seeing some experience come forward here now, Mel, as the game is starting to wind down.
Chris Anderson. Gent with that Marine haircut, and he plays like a Marine, like he's at Guadalcanal. Mel Proctor with Billy Packer. We're at St. John Arena. Sellout crowd here as the Ohio State Buckeyes have put their 30-game home win streak on the line. And they cut the Indiana lead to six on two free throws by Gent, who will leave the game as Tom Brandewee comes back.
And you notice how ineffective a guy like Bill Robinson would be in this game, and the fact that the game is just too quick for him. So Brandewee is the right substitution.
Jackson moves out to pick up Damon Bailey.
Yeah, which means that Cheney is being guarded by Brandewee.
And Bailey throws it away. That's the eighth turnover by Indiana.
Not real good patience by Damon Bailey, because you've got Brandewee going to try to guard Cheney because Jackson has got to move over. Now, now's the time to let Cheney handle the ball.
You see Jackson move into the backcourt and said, give me the ball.
Right.
Jackson on the tip.
Now, Indiana can counter that. They can counter that now by getting Cheney the ball some.
Eric Anderson blocked by Funderburk, but there's a foul.
You know, if you've got a shot blocker like Funderburk, and where he's so effective is he's blocking not his man's shot today as much as he is coming over on help defense. So you just got to play solid. Figure Funderburk will eventually get there to make the block once it's released.
Of course, Lawrence Funderburk and Bobby Knight had their differences. So Funderburk went to Indiana after six games his freshman year. He was kicked out of practice, left the school, went to a junior college, and then came back.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Why foul? Just play solid down there, because you know Funderburk is going to come over and be able to make the block.
Funderburk told us something else was interesting yesterday. We said, if we could go in a time tunnel back to 89, where would you go to school? And he said, probably Louisville or North Carolina.
Now, so far this year in Indiana's four losses, and three of those games, the opponent shot over 50%. You can see that they're keeping Ohio State down under 50 at 46. Indiana, a big advantage with a three-point outside shooting, and Cheney having a great game offensively.
11:48 remaining second half. Indiana leads by six. First place in the Big Ten at stake. Jim Jackson beginning to assert himself.
Now, he has been known as a great second half player. Last year, 60% of his points came in the second half, but right now he's starting to put the ball in his hands, as we suggested, and just taking over the game offensively.
Jackson with a steal.
Good pass.
Brandaway blocked by
Henderson.
Yep, the freshman gets the rejection.
Cheney with Brown now on him.
Funderburk with a steal.
Got to get the pass off.
What a defensive game he's played. Six blocks and now a steal. Jackson got it going now.
I can't imagine that Indiana would allow Jim Jackson to put the ball on the floor for about 30 feet. You know what he's going to do with it. Tremendous crowd action right here now. Why it's so tough to win on the road.
Indiana leading by two. Henderson, the freshman, not rattled by this crowd. Oh, what a block by Funderburk. He gets another one. The Buckeyes have it rolling now. Baker's pass deflected by Cheney.
Now you wonder how long Lawrence Funderburk can stay out there without a little breather. I mean, we're down 10 minutes in this half. He has not been out yet. Here he is again, coming over from the weak side. These blocks have all been against somebody else's man. That's his seventh in the game. And he's keeping them in play. You know, the old Bill Russell days. You know, not only block him and don't smack him out of bounds, keep him in play for your teammates.
Funderburk, nice dish to Brandaway.
Big run for Ohio State. First time that they have been in the lead in this half, or tie in this half.
It's been led by the defense of Funderburk and the scoring of Jim Jackson, and we're tied at 62. 10 minutes left. Chris Reynolds, 21 in the game for the Hoosiers. Into Cheney.
He had Brown on his back.
Baker using his quickness. Funderburk crashes the boards.
Well, you know, Ohio State right now, Mel, they got to remember Jim Jackson brought him back with the ball in his hands. All of a sudden, they get away from it. Once they get in a tie position, you got to let him continue offensively.
Cheney. Got it. Three-pointer by Calvert Cheney.
I think this is a good timeout situation for Ohio State here and just say, hey, guys, let's remember what brought us back. I mean, they cannot afford now. They're down five. This is a very important possession for them.
Two great players going head-to-head. Jackson for a three. Just missed it. Chris Reynolds hustles in and battles Brandaway, who picks up the foul.
Now, I still feel that Ohio State needs a timeout right here to get everything back in order. They made a real run. Funderburk's a little tired. And we got a timeout coming.
So Randy Ayers apparently agrees with you. He'll take a timeout. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Mel Proctor with Billy Packer back in Columbus with Indiana leading 67-62. Calvert Cheney has been the story offensively for Indiana with a total of 26 points. Jim Jackson has 16 for Ohio State. .850 remaining in the game.
Hey, it's really fun to watch Jackson matched up on Cheney on both ends of the floor. Two of the best in the country. There, Jackson's holding. Oh, without question, he had his arm right around the back of him. And there are three referees out here, and they can spot that real easily. There's no way you might pull that off in the playground, but you don't get it away here.
That's his third foul and the sixth team foul. Jackson really started to get it going in the second half, and the Buckeyes, for some reason, went away from him. Randy Ayers says sometimes he waits too long for the game to come to him, and that was a point of emphasis today, to try to get him going early.
You got to be thinking about getting Cheney the ball in the low post. Maybe pick up Jackson's fourth.
Bailey checks the clock.
Yeah, he sure did.
20 seconds left on the shot clock.
Good call, Matt, because he looked right up there to see where they were.
Now they've got to start looking for a shot with 10 left on the clock. It's down to six. Bailey puts it up.
Boy, Brandaway, big enough to make that shot more difficult than that for Bailey, but Bailey
cool head out there.
After a slow start, Damon Bailey now has 15 points, and the Hoosiers lead by 7.
Now on this end, it's Janie on Jackson. Jent gets a good screen over and a step out.
Jent's playing with 3 fouls. Jackson posting up Damon Bailey. Got it.
See, Indiana switches. And so therefore, Jackson's got to be patient enough to get himself when he's in the low post with Bailey as opposed to with Cheney. Cheney on an illegal screen on Brown got by with him.
Jim Jackson now has 18 points. The Hoosiers lead by 5. Cheney with the open shot. Boy, he hasn't missed many today. 28 points for Calvert Cheney.
Well, you've got a situation where Indiana wants to get Funderburk back in the game. He's got him sitting on the sidelines. You don't want to call a timeout to get him in, but he really needs to stop any action here because they've got to go with Funderburk the rest of the way.
Jackson backs down on Bailey. And a push called on Damon Bailey.
But see, Ohio State's looking for Jackson now. I mean, they're taking their time. Here comes this to allow Funderburk to get back in the game. Brandon, we probably sit.
Funderburk has 7 block shots today. That's within 2 of the school record of 9 held by Brad Sellers and Herb Williams, both who went on to play in the NBA. And Funderburk replaces Brandewee. .646 left in the game. The Hoosiers lead by 7.
Good help.
Turns it over.
That's good help by Reynolds.
That's a 6th turnover by Ohio State.
And Ohio State goes zone. Trying to save Jackson and Funderburk a little bit here. Now you got Bailey. You can let Reynolds take his shot. You got to be careful about Cheney and Bailey here.
Bailey with the entry pass to Matt Nover, who runs it in.
Oh, big shot!
A 9-point lead for Indiana with just over 6 minutes left, and a steal by Allen Henderson. He cashes in. A big play by the freshman. He's had a tremendous game with 20 points.
Reniers wants his team to force it down. 5:55 to go. Huge turnover.
Jackson against Bailey. And a foul call on Damon Bailey, who's giving away 3 inches to Jim Jackson.
Yeah, I think Ohio State should try as much as possible to make that matchup take place. That being Bailey on Jackson. And Jackson just worked for a screen until Bailey gets over on him. Now here you see that's the setup. Pass it out, post right up, down low. He'll come back to the ball. See, now the switch goes the other way, and Cheney's on him.
Cheney did a good job of denying the pass to Jackson. Jamal Brown misses the shot, the rebound to Nover, who's made a couple of big plays. He's coming in. Calvert Cheney.
Baker almost had that time perfectly.
Bailey misses a 3-pointer, but there's a foul underneath.
That was Cheney coming over the back of Funderburk. That's his 3rd.
They have a 16th foul.
This game, in my estimation, considering the quality of the 2 teams and the effort being put in, has been very well officiated. I mean, they've let the kids play. It's not been a parade to the foul line.
If Indiana wins, they'll open up a game and a half lead over Ohio State in the Big Ten.
Indiana has to go to Michigan and to go to Iowa.
Mark Baker with the open jumper. And it's 75-66, Indiana with 5 minutes left.
You notice now that's his range, right inside the 3-point line. Going to come in for the double team.
Half-court trap by the Buckeyes. And Bailey is fouled by Baker. Indiana's outscored Ohio State 13-4 over the last 5 minutes and 20 seconds.
And of course, Bailey, as they start getting on the foul line now, was 14-for-14 against Ohio State in that first game.
I mentioned the legend of Damon Bailey. Of course, the story is well told, how Bobby Knight found out about Bailey when he was playing in the 8th grade, went to see him play, and at that time envisioned him as a great college player. He went on to become the all-time leading scorer in Indiana high school history and was recruited by Bobby. Jackson against Bailey.
Bailey just cannot handle him. That's the matchup Ohio State has got to get in place
the rest of this ball game.
20 points now for Jim Jackson. 4.5 remaining. The Hoosiers lead by 7. Bailey trying to save, but he's out of bounds. As the Hoosiers turn it over, their 11th turnover of the game.
Now, Bob Knight did not like that action by Chris Reynolds.
Tom Brandaway replaces Chris Gent for Ohio State.
Just no need to make that play. Keep the dribble alive and make the easy pass.
He'd be well advised to get the ball in the hands of Jim Jackson, I would think.
Well, let's see the matchup again. It's Bailey over here on the side. A long pass.
They wanted to go on the alley-oop to Funderburk.
Kind of beating a dead horse here, Mel, but you got to let Jackson handle that ball every time down to keep the pressure on Indiana.
Baker trying to draw a charge.
Good no call.
We're under 4 minutes. Indiana leads by 7. Henderson playing like a senior today.
Came off that screen perfectly.
22 points for the freshman, Allen Henderson. That's his career high.
What he does is square up so well at the basket.
Jackson misses the shot. Funderburk may have been fouled by Bailey.
Great hands by Bailey inside. Ohio State in serious trouble now.
Down by 9 with 3:30 left.
Nober, another big basket or attempt.
Fouled by Funderburk.
Now, Jim Jackson is still complaining to the official about what happened down on the other end of the floor. That's not going to do him any good now. I thought Bailey came away with a pretty good steal. The official had a better look at it than we did.
I thought maybe he got hit on the arm, to be honest with him. Chris Jett is back in, replacing Brandaway. And Matt Nober will go to the line. Nober's kind of an interesting player. Not a big scorer, but he comes in there and sets some good picks in this Indiana passing game offense. He has the only 2 points off the Hoosier bench today. That is a junior from Chesterton, Indiana.
Well, Indiana was after Sean Kemp. He was one of the great players to come out of that that state in a long time. Of course, now playing in the pros. And Chris Mills is now out at Arizona. Lost both of those, and Nover got the scholarship.
And we get a timeout with 3:24 left. Indiana leads by 10. Packer back at St. John Arena in Columbus, Ohio, with the Indiana Hoosiers leading by 10 in the battle for first place in the Big Ten.
Now, you'd like some penetration and some passes back out for three-point shots. The guy you'd probably want out there is Gent, and he's down in the low post.
Chris Gent delivers to make it 78-70, Indiana. Just over 3 minutes left.
I mean, you don't have to take wild threes, but Jimmy Jackson's penetration and then the dish back outside.
Traveling called on Damon Bailey as the press forces a turnover.
And what happened to Damon is everybody ran off and left him. That really wasn't his fault. Jackson, a good three-point shooter as well.
Henderson makes another big play. Great play by the freshman who's had a tremendous game.
That was his second steal and almost was able to run away with that one and dunk it like he did the first time.
He scored a career-high 22 points today and made 2 fine defensive plays. His previous career high was 20.
Now talk about a turnaround. Didn't play in the first game, so that's 22 they didn't even touch.
He had strep throat, missed the first game in Bloomington. Foul is called on Chris Gent. That's his 4th. And the 9th team foul.
Well, taking the part of Ohio State the rest of the way, they've got to think about getting Funderburk inside for rebounding. Gent's probably their most solid, at least today, the most solid three-point shooter. Seemed to me that they'd want to penetrate, dish back out, try to get Gent or Jim Jackson some threes.
23 points now for Henderson, who was runner-up Mr. Basketball in the state of Indiana. Mr. Basketball was Glenn Robinson, a Prop 48 player at Purdue. And he gives the Hoosiers an 80-70 lead with 2:30 left.
Bad timing.
Trying to get it to Jackson.
See, Baker taking a shot. That's just a 2. That doesn't do you any good from there.
Out of bounds to Ohio State with 2:18 remaining.
What's cost Ohio State here, Mel, and it was pretty obvious, is that when they made their nice run behind Jackson, they went away from him. They got the score to tie, and then just didn't let him have the ball.
Jackson now has 22 points. There's an old saying, you dance with who brung you. And Jackson brought him back, but they went away from him.
Wow. Did he call against Jackson?
Yep.
He made the steal. And then Henderson just happened to be in his way.
That's his fourth foul, too. It's also the 10th team foul.
See him go up. He makes the good steal. See, Henderson is still in the way, and as they come down, Henderson happens to be the one off balance and falls.
So Henderson will go back to the line, this time shooting two free throws. Which that's the 10th foul. Indiana today, 10 out of 13 at the free throw line.
Kind of interesting. Jackson has only fouled out of one game, and that was, of course, the game the other night against Iowa.
So Henderson leaves the door open, missing both free throws. 2 minutes left, an 8-point Indiana lead. It's JJ time.
They're sending five men up onto the board. Indiana can break them.
Reynolds and Bailey bring it up against the pressure.
David Bailey wanting to get fouled. That's going to be offensive.
He was trying to draw a foul, exactly. But he charged.
He was trying so hard to be fouled instead of giving up the ball because he wanted to go on the line, feeling that he could make him. He should have given up the pass. You can see him right here. He's holding on to it. He's holding on to it. He's hoping he can get fouled. There was the easy pass to make right away.
Ohio State trailing by 8. The Buckeyes have just one timeout left.
Now, in the last 15 years, Indiana has won 8 of the games here by an average of 9 points a game. When Ohio State wins, it's a 2-point margin. So Indiana has won 8. Ohio State's won 7. And it looks like this is an Indiana margin type game right now. They're at 6.
Chris Jens basket cutting the lead to 6, but a foul is called on Mark Baker. And Billy, you know, Jamal Brown and Mark Baker combined for 20 points in the second half. Between them, they have only 4 in the second half. So in Jim Jackson's defense, he's had to carry a little more of the load than he'd like to.
Yeah, 20 in the first half. And exactly. Brown has not even scored here in the second half.
Chris Reynolds, who's only a 56% free throw shooter, will go to the line.
He's who you want on the line if you're Ohio State. Henderson misses 2. Here's the man you want on the line. He drills the first.
Reynolds, a junior from Peoria, Illinois. His first point of the game.
Hits the pair. Probably wouldn't even been out here if Pat Graham hadn't gotten injured early in the year because it was intended to redshirt him.
Baker.
Nice pull-up jump shot.
And Ohio State using their last timeout. So it's 82-76 Indiana with just a minute 5 left from Columbus.
Analysis of today's game featuring comments from Randy.
Regulation game. It was 77-72 IU here. The game ended up going double overtime. It's awful close to that score right now.
Ohio State is out of timeouts. And a foul called on Jamal Brown of the Buckeyes. That's his first. And every foul now a 2-shot situation for Indiana. You've been friends, Billy, with Bob Knight over the years. Do you think he's mellowed at all?
Well, I think that his marital situation right now is the best that it's ever been in his life. And I think Karen, his wife, who is a former coach and a person who he considers to be very knowledgeable in basketball, has had a lot to do with the way he is responding on the court and with his team.
He can still get excited, but he seems a little more controlled on the sideline than he was years ago. A little more. A fraction percentage point.
He says, I'd rather be thought of as a great teacher than a great coach.
Less than a minute remaining. Gent unloads a 3. And Jamal Brown commits a foul. That'll send Greg Graham to the line, a pretty good free throw shooter at 76%.
I think when you're trying to make a comeback like that, it's very difficult to take 3-point shots just spotting up out there. I think it's a lot easier if you have somebody who's designated to be the penetrator. Penetrate in, make them slough off on you a little bit, and then fire out for the jump shot so you can get into a nice motion. Gent just tried to do it all by himself there, and that's tough.
Greg Graham, who had a 25-point effort in the first matchup against Ohio State, now has six.
Kind of upset with himself there, has played really well in the starting role.
And it looks like this 30-game home win streak is about to come to an end. The last team to beat Ohio State here was Michigan State in February of 1990. And their 30-game home win streak is second longest in the country to UNLV's 46-game streak.
See, there's the same thing. It's Jackson just trying to go straight up for the jumper. Defense can be squared up right with him. You talk about win streaks. We had Jerry Lucas on earlier in this half. When he and Knight and Melnall and that crew played here in those three outstanding years for Ohio State, they never lost on this court. 34-0.
Wow. Damon Bailey looking for the foul, doesn't get it.
Henderson's wide open. They just want to use clock here.
And now Bailey will go to the line to shoot two after being fouled by Mark Baker. That's his fourth foul. And two shots coming up for Damon Bailey.
Now it's going to be very interesting for Ohio State. They've got to count on some of their other foes in the Big Ten to get them back into this race. And as I said, Indiana's got a tough road game playing at Michigan. They also have to go to Iowa. I think this league is looking at six teams in the NCAA tournament the way they're playing right now.
Damon Bailey, after a slow start, has 16 points and hit two of the biggest baskets of the game. A three-pointer late in the first half to give his team the lead. And then a desperation three-pointer as the half came to an end. Baker to Jackson for the jam. And it's 86-78 Hoosiers with just 16 seconds left.
Fred is everywhere. Oh, and how about that smart move by Reynolds, realizing the ball's going everywhere, and as long as his team had possession, they had timeouts left, he called one. Very smart play.
With 8.1 seconds left, Indiana has an 8-point lead. The Hoosiers will improve their record to 20-4 with a win today and would go 11-2 in conference play and would open up a game and a half lead over Ohio State.
Just giving up the basket, knowing that they don't even have to take the ball out of bounds now. Ohio State out of timeouts. Smart play by Indiana.
Mark Baker with the uncontested jam, but Bob Knight's Indiana Hoosiers have come in here to St. John Arena and beaten Ohio State, ending the Buckeyes' 30-game home win streak. That's Norm Ellenberger, the assistant coach.
He doesn't want to smile, but he's smiling on the inside.
Indiana now 20-4. There should be a shakeup in the ratings. The Hoosiers ranked seventh. They'll probably move up as they beat Ohio State 86-80. Columbia.
The Indiana Hoosiers lead.